Good day. Welcome to the Great White North, where it is so freaking cold that bubbles freeze within mere seconds. And as they freeze, they look good. Like, they look really good. So in this video, I'm going to give you 10 helpful tips, directions, 10 helpful steps on how to capture bubbles freezing. Although not really capture either, more like record, video, film. I don't know, just watch. Finding commercially pre-made bubble solution in the dead of winter can be hard to say the least. I visited a number of stores and I was laughed at every single time. I ended up ordering this online. However, if you're in the middle of a short-lived cold snap and you can't wait for FedEx to drop bubble solution off at your front door, you can actually make your own homemade bubble solution. It's really quite simple. There are only three things you need. Number one, dish soap. Preferably Dawn, it's a bit lighter than the other stuff. Glycerin. And plain old water. The order in which you combine these ingredients makes no difference. I'm starting with 500 milliliters of water. That's 2 cups. 60 milliliters of dish soap, or 1/4 cup. 30 milliliters of glycerin, or 2 tablespoons. And mix it all together. And there you have it, your homemade bubble solution. They'll freeze outside, not here. All right, we got some cola, some purple stuff, some Sunny D, oh, and bubbles. Keep your bubbles chilled. If the temperature of the solution isn't already close to freezing, you're gonna have a challenging time creating bubbles that last. And those that do survive are gonna be without those psychedelic crystals swirling in the middle.
It is a fine line between keeping your bubble solution chilled and having it freeze, well, outdoors. So it's best to decant only a small amount and leave the rest inside.
The surface you choose for your bubbles can impact how easily they form and how long they last. It needs to be relatively smooth and rather flat. Raw wood is a little too rough, paper's just gonna get soggy. I used a piece of acrylic that seemed to work rather well, and it also provided some nice reflections. Now, just as the bubble solution needed to be chilled, the surface you choose also needs to be cold. So if you're using something that was indoors, the bubbles will actually freeze from the top down because the base has some residual heat. The wind is going to be your nemesis while trying to blow bubbles, and I can tell you from personal experience, it is worth taking the time and finding somewhere sheltered from the wind before blowing a single bubble. The frustration encountered while trying to blow bubbles in the wind, it just doesn't make for a fun experience. Now, if it's continuously windy and your bubbles are constantly popping, you may want to add a bit more glycerin to that bubble solution, and that may do the trick. Lighting a freezing bubble is about as tricky as lighting a frosty beverage glass for a product shot. The bubble begins completely transparent, incredibly reflective, but then in a second it's translucent and no longer reflective. I tried a few different lighting options to say the least. I tried hard light, I tried soft light, one light, two lights, one light below, two lights below. Ultimately, the only thing that gave me the look I was after was the sun super low on the horizon backlighting the bubble. Unfortunately, the sun doesn't like to spend a lot of time hanging out near the horizon this time of year, so it's really important to be prepared well in advance, which is hopefully why you're watching this video.
Perspective is everything when filming the bubbles freeze. Your camera has to be at the exact same level as the bubble's base. If it's too high, the semi-transparent crystals will disappear against a background that lacks contrast. To help with that, you can add your own dark background, but be careful not to obscure the backlight of the ever-important sun.
Hopefully this goes without saying. Cold weather is one of the primary ingredients in capturing images of frozen bubbles. It's also something you need to know how to battle as a photographer. And if you need help with that, watch my video, Photography in Extreme Cold. I'll also link it at the end of this video. For a bubble to freeze before it inevitably pops, the temperature needs to be somewhere near minus 10 degrees Celsius. For our southern neighbors, the only country in the world that doesn't understand Celsius, that's something like positive 14 degrees Fahrenheit. Also keep in mind, the colder it is, the faster a bubble will freeze. And anything below minus 30 degrees Celsius, the bubble will freeze so quickly you need a high-speed camera, something like a Phantom Flex, so it's probably not worth your time. For this next bit, I have added some black paper to the surface. That's just to make it easier for you to see what I'm talking about, and not something I would recommend that you do when capturing your own images. Now, when recording video of the bubbles freezing, attaining proper focus can be rather challenging. Autofocus in this situation is useless. The frame, it begins empty, the bubbles, they're transparent, just don't bother with autofocus. Now, predicting where the edge of a bubble will form is equally challenging, the first time. You see, once one bubble has been blown, freezes, and pops, it kind of creates a frozen bubble footprint. And subsequent bubbles blown within that footprint typically have the same edge. So blow one sacrificial bubble, manually focus on it, pop that bubble, and blow and record the next ones. It's much easier. How many times did I say bubble? Like 20?
Straws come in many shapes, sizes, and colors, and for the purpose of blowing bubbles that freeze, the straw you use doesn't really make a difference. This straw is from the International Drainage Commission in Springfield. Interestingly, the Southern Hemisphere version has the spiral in the opposite direction. It's also said to cost $900 dues. With this straw, you need to use abnormally large white gloves, and my personal favorite, the Elder Straw, is said to have once been owned by J.K. Rowling herself. You don't need to be a rocket scientist to understand you can drink a liquid without using a straw, and that straws suck. That is to say, 500 million straws are used every day in the United States, and they're not always disposed of properly, greatly contributing to plastic marine debris. So take this opportunity to find yourself a forever straw and say goodbye to those unnecessary single-use straws that suck.
Whether you're shooting photos or videos, the camera you choose makes no difference. I've done this using an iPhone. Though it does help to have a macro lens, it's not necessary at all. Any lens at its minimum focusing distance will be adequate. As you've seen through the XF information accompanying all the B-roll in this video, I shot using a relatively small aperture. That gave me a large depth of field and means as much of the bubble as possible was in focus. Now, for the real camera nerds out there, you may have noticed some strange coloration in those ice crystals, and that is not chromatic aberration. It's actually the ice crystals acting like a prism and refracting the different wavelengths of light. Do I sound like Bill Nye yet? All right, if you've made it this far, your fingers and your toes are probably numb just from watching. But now you know how to capture imagery of bubbles freezing. So get to it, and I encourage you to be creative. Try food coloring, try long exposures with moonlight, try blowing multiple bubbles at once. If you have liked this video, click like. If you have a suggestion, put it down below. If you've refined this process or you've been creative yourself, let everybody else know in those comments. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Also, stay warm. Definitely stay warm.